Hello, my name's Jason and welcome to another episode of me drawing. Now, today we're going to be drawing an orange, more specifically clementine or clementine. Not actually sure how you say it. I should have chose a satsuma. Would have been easier. Oh well, never mind. we're going to be using the colour soft orange just to get this one started. Then we're going to use a pro marker. We're going to sort of mix our media up a little bit. Just to show that you can, really. So, just getting the shape of the orange, the peel. Orange peel. So it goes to about there. And then it comes up. And then round, and down. It's sort of more flat at the base. Being quite rough with my initial sketch, because and light as well, just so I can check back and forth to my photo to make sure that I'm doing it about right. I've done one of these before, not exactly the same, but I'm using the technique I tried before and it seemed to work quite well. Okay, and now the segment is sort of here. I actually chopped this orange in half, this clementine, using a knife, and when I chopped it off, it was actually perfect inside. I mean, you could see the white on the segments, and it was like the perfect chop. Destiny for me to get a good picture of an orange chopped in half. Okay, something like this. Is that about right? It doesn't look quite right over here because it's a little bit bigger over here on the picture. That's more like it. Yeah, there's only a slight difference, but it made a difference. And then there's a loose piece sort of stuck out here. Something like that. Let's see. It's quite hard to see when you're using the orange to sketch, but it makes it better at a later date. let's see if this would fit inside there. Just about. This is just a technique to show you how to do it. You can do yours much better. That's the way I think of all my episodes, really. That the viewer can get an idea of what to do and then improve upon it. Make their picture better. Okay, grabbing my pro marker. Now I've gone for amber in colour. Amber in colour, because it seemed to work quite well. I'm using really old paper, by the way. Okay. I'll just use the smaller side just to get this bit a bit more accurate. We're just sort of blocking in colour at the moment. Just blocking it in. using the pro marker. Okay. And then we can change things and develop things a little better when we start using the pencil crayons. And then we've got a orange bit on there. Sort of on the outside bit. Again, this can be improved upon when we move on to pencil crayons again. Side again. I find it helps to go in the angle of the orange, where the segments are. There we go. Went a bit quicker on that side because we used the big end to make it. Okay, let's just tidy this bit up a little bit like that. There is actually some dark bits that go on the inside, but don't worry too much about those bits yet, because again, the pencil crayons will improve things. Okay, there's a little bit of a break in the peel there, so let's put that in. And that. Like that. Now, something else I should mention, as I'm using an easel, it restricts me to turning the page when drawing, but when you do turn the page, it can make it easier for yourself. Okay, there's a bit of a there and there as well. Okay, I'm going on to some tulip yellow pro marker. And we'll look at doing the of yellow that's inside the peel here. Okay, there's a bit there. And here. And you can see some yellow there as well. And there. Okay, and let's fill this in as well. You can use like this angle, just makes it easier to fill in. So this reminds me of like oil painting as well, when you're just blocking an area in with colour ready to put highlights on. It's just the same really. We'll just change again to this bit. Let's get that bit there. Yeah, just the same. What you sort of think of, if you have done oil painting, then you could think of this stage as the blocking in phase, and then the pencil crayon stages, like the refining. That's how I see it. Right, let's have a look now. So as this is ink is drying, we can start working on the shadow areas on the inside, and I've got this white grey to do that. Looking at it, I'm not sure if this is showing up on camera. I might get a slightly darker grey out of my happy box of pencils. Yeah, maybe this one will work better. Cloud blue. Yeah, this is a nicer colour. It's definitely better. There's a bit of a shadow here as well. Where the peel's slightly bigger than the orange, so it's casting its shadow. We can put that in now. Yeah, now it's a case of building it up, building up the details, refining it to make it look more realistic, really. And how realistic can you go is up to you. Just picked up the bright orange just to darken this area in here. I could probably go a bit darker. We'll start with this for now anyway. Let's try a bit of darkish white in here. Looked back to make sure my head wasn't in shot. That does happen sometimes. Okay. Right. Now this is basically how it works now. I'm using orange now. Switch from pencil crayon. Pencil crayon to pen. Okay, now what we can do is we can refine some of this. I'm just going to give this a little bit of texture just by going across. Some dark areas along here as well. One that sort of goes like that. Some there. This is really. Yeah, we're really looking for the detail here, looking at the shapes and things, and then sitting back, having a look. See, this is a little darker. As well, it's just a bit darker, so let's put that in. Areas that are got a little bit more depth to them, put them in, because I want to try and make this orange look more realistic. This is a bit darker above here. This under here as well. Okay. But like I said, you can keep moving with this, keep refining, keep looking at the photo and look and see what's different to your picture, to the photo, or what can you improve on. That's something I've noticed, there's a bit more yellow feeding into here. So, and there, and there. So put it in. If there's more of something, right there I can see some white. Now we can start really developing things. Sort of a white bit there. Goes across that one as well. Got to sort of sit back and have a look. Keep sitting back and having a look. Looking at the patterns. Patterns that are on the orange. I'm adding them. Isn't this white? Got a little bit of grey on that. just get my pencil sharpener, just sharpen that. All kinds of patterns and things on here. So you sort of need to have a bit of patience and group there. And yeah, you just get a bit of patience and keep looking and refining the white there. I think we can improve this area a bit more. It's sort of got a line on it. Yeah, that's better. There's even a bit of yellow just there. Put it in. Let's start looking at this area. There's quite a lot of white there. Looking at details. They sort of remind me of like veins in the orange, and they're like that. Sort of a shape here, let's put that shape in. Cut here, dog barking. Still dog barking. The dog has stopped barked. Okay, now let's get the darker colours there. The darker bits here. Okay. This sort of looks rounded here. So we'll do that. It has a shape to it. I just used a bit of white there. Sorry, my dog just made a bit of a noise then. Looking at all the different patterns. Something like that. Line in there. Some little thicker bits there as well. And okay, I'm sort of looking at darker areas. Just going to start zipping around the picture, darkening these bits that look darker on the picture. Just using the bright orange again. Makes a good darkening colour actually. Shape in there. Okay. A white over there. Okay, that's better. Now I'm going to go on to the white gel pen. Pick up some of these lines. Make them more stand out a bit. Problem I find with the white gel pen is I can't use it on an angle. Never mind, I'll carry on. I'm getting there. I just need to do those highlights. Okay, I've just grabbed myself some white acrylic for my highlights. I'm using this. It's a Italia titanium white. I bought a load when I first started out as a when I was starting painting, and I haven't used it very much. I started with acrylics and then moved on to oil paints, and now using acrylics again. Okay, I'm just using a little bit of white. I'm going to pick up the some of these bits which need highlighting. This is a good way to highlight some of the areas. It's quite nice to use some paint as well. This is a proper mixed media idea. I'm using a Cotman and a Newton brush. Is it number one? Number one, lucky number one. It's a watercolour brush. Any fine watercolour brush really will do. This is just to pick out some of the highlights. You can even use this quite thin as well for some of the transparent areas. Just add a little bit more water. Okay, and then the outside edge. That's quite nice, that thick line, because there is a chunk that's stuck out there. So that gives it a bit more texture as well. Let's do this line here. Isn't it fun doing this? Starting with a blank white piece of paper, and then next minute you've got an orange on it. Painting's amazing. Just use my finger to remove paint there, because it didn't need quite so much. Just using very thin paint there. Yeah. It goes in like that. Use your finger to soften and to remove needs be. I do a lot of that when doing oil painting. Use your finger to sort of dab it, gets rid of some of the problem areas. And you put a little bit of paint on there and you can just dab it with your finger like this, and you're removing some of the paint. Yeah, that'll do for that one for now, and we'll move on to the other one. White pencil. I want the off-white, the white grey first, because this bit is slightly in shadow. So from about there is in shadow. So let's see if this one works. It's a little too dark. I want to be able to see it. Start putting in all the different white marks, just like we did on the other one. And then we can use our orange. Do is shade all of this area. That does look good. And then a little darker in the areas that look a bit darker. Yeah. And here we go. Carry on with our white. See some good areas where I can use the acrylic there. I'm going in quite fast here, looking at all the little lines and just putting them in, just really, really going for it. Not really worried, just getting in there. Okay, yeah, it's coming on. Now it's got some acrylic again. The thing that used to frustrate me with acrylic is the way it dries so fast. I know you can get like different versions of acrylic now, like open acrylic or whatever. It stops drying so quick, but I don't really know anything about it. I've never used it. I've always just gone, well, it's acrylic, dries quick, gotta paint quick. And I never really put that much on my palette either. I was like, oh, it dries quick, so I'll lose my money quick. So I'll be really stingy with it. It's sort of going down like that. It does look good, this white. Looks good enough to taste. Don't know why. I feel like picking this piece of orange up and eating it. I did that earlier actually, after I took a photo. There's it. That's the beauty of doing still lifes, I think. Get stuff you want to eat. Draw it and, well, eat it, draw it. And then you're getting really, into the subject. You can taste the orange in your mouth as you're drawing it. Okay. Nice doing the line there. Yeah. Bring this out of the shadows a bit because I've drawn it further away than where it was. So there you go. That's about right. Let's have a look. Can I? Anything here? A little bit. Here. There as well. Yep, I'm just sort of looking for bits that need a bit extra. Now there is areas. Whoops, just dropped my palette, which wasn't actually a palette. I won't tell you what I was using, because you'd think I'm a bit weird. Now I'll let the secret out. I bought some new razor blades, and it's the packet that they go in. I used it as my little easel. My palette. Because it's just plastic, you see. Put acrylic on it quite easily. Right, let's put a shadow on this. So that you've got light coming in this way, so the shadow would probably be. Can't really see the shadow on the photo. It's not. There's other stuff in it, so it's not as clear as it should be. I'd say it's about there. Something like that, anyway. And then the shadow would be like that. Let's just darken that a bit. Like I said, the shadow is not perfect. Something along those lines. And I think it would be even darker underneath that bit there. So I'll just darken that bit there. This blue as well. That'll do for our shadow. We know it's not perfect, but it'll do. Okay, and now looking at it, peel the sides, not quite right. Okay. Yeah. Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode. This shows you a little bit more what you can do. I've used a little bit of all sorts. Used some acrylic pencils. Pens, nice mixture, and like to say thanks for watching as always, and I hope this helps you out in some way. And I just put that in there, just needs a little bit there. That needs a bit there. Oh, there's a bit of green there. Let's put it in. And there. Okay, yeah. Thanks so much for watching this one. It's a nice, fun one to do. They're all fun to do, really. I could keep going, adding little extra bits to improve and improve. Eventually, you've got to say. At the end of the day, you have to admit to yourself that this one is finished. Thanks so much for watching this one, and like I said, hope it helps you out, and I'll see you in another one. Cheers, bye.